late one night, when my eyes beheld an eerie sight, for my monster from his slab began to rise, and suddenly, to my surprise,
he did the mash.
He did the monster mash.
The monster mash.
It was a graveyard smash.
He did the mash.
It got on in a flash.
He did the mash.
He did the monster mash. In my laboratory in the castle east, the master bedroom at the vampire's feast. The
ghouls. Oh, Brian's a terrible doctor.
Good morning, everyone.
Are the mics on?
And welcome to
so I can
this
speak to?
Halloween.
But I can't
edition.
Hear myself.
Muhammad.
Hello?
Thank
Hello?
You.
Hello? Ah! Okay, no, that was mine.
It's Halloween. This isn't a time for order. Welcome, everyone, to this Halloween edition of the Jeffersonian Show for WHIT Radio. Today, as you have heard, we have Muhammad, Nisar, Brian, Natalia, Alyssa, and I, Leah. Today, we're going to be talking about a bunch of different monsters that are very popular during Halloween time. And first, we're going to start with Muhammad, who's going to be talking about the New Jersey Devil, which, as we know, has been haunting New Jersey for a long time. Muhammad?
Okay, so as Leah just told you, I'm going to be talking about the New Jersey Devil, who is supposed to be a mythical creature of the, you know, that originated from the New Jersey Pinelands, and this myth has started over 260 years ago. It has been supposedly spotted about 2,000 times, and it's at one point there was a reward given in certain towns in South Jersey about for the New Jersey Devil's capture. That's how real people actually started believing in, that's how much people actually started believing in the New Jersey Devil's existence. The best explanation for this legend is that nothing more than a made up story by English settlers that were scared of the Pine Barrens of Southern Jersey. There are people to this day that still believe that the creature exists. The devil is described as having the head of a dog with the face of a horse, deer-like antlers, a kangaroo's body, large leathery wings, a forked reptilian tail, cloven hooves, and a long razor-like claws. It's a pretty scary mythical creature.
That's incredible. Once there's so many descriptive words used for one creature, you kind of get that it's not real. What do you guys think about this?
Well, at one point, you know, when they offered the reward, there was actually a few rewards offered. I think Camden offered a reward years ago for the creature. I'm not sure how much exactly they offered, but...
That's interesting. Well, now we have Brian, who's going to be talking about black cats.
Alrighty, so there's some facts about the black cat. Black cats are occasionally bad luck on Friday the 13th. This is superstition dates all the way back to the Dark Ages, when witch hunts were common and occurred often. Elderly women that lived alone or in solitude were often accused of witchcraft. Their pet cats were said to be black cats, that they were familiars or demonic animals that had been given to them by the devil. There is a myth that Satan turns himself into a cat when he socializes with witches. And finally, black cats are not bad luck everywhere. In Ireland, Scotland, and England, is considered good luck when you see a black cat.
That's interesting. I've heard that it's not just black cats, but any cat.
I heard that too.
During the time of the witch hunts,
if
there was an old lady that was kind of warty and had a cat, that's it. She was a witch. All right. So how about you, Nisar? You're talking about Dracula today, right?
Yep. My favorite. All right. So basically, Dracula is a vampire. Who is a person who doesn't die, whose corpse rises from their grave during the nighttime and tries to suck the blood of living creatures. By the time dawn comes around, the vampire needs to return back to their grave because they'll die if they go into the sun. Magicians, witches, excommunicated people, criminals, babies born with teeth, unbaptized children, and the seventh son of the seventh son all can become vampires. Dracula might have been inspired by Vlad the Impaler, and Dracula is the saliva of bats, which is named after Dracula, so that's how Dracula got his name. and he remains the most famous Gothic villain of all time, so he's my favorite. Oh, and Dracula is his last name, not his first, so nobody knows what his first name is.
That's interesting, especially since Vlad the Impaler was a lot more violent than I've ever seen Dracula be, with killing his own people and just impaling them with stakes and putting them all over his country. That's pretty bad.
Right. Oh, we have a caller.
Let's see who it is.
Can't hear anything.
Hello?
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 Yes?
This is Dracula.
Hello, Dracula.
My brother.
I must say I'm from Transylvania.
Transylvania.
How's mom?
She's good. A little pale.
She's a little pale?
Yes.
Give her some blood, bro.
Yes.
Send our regards.
Send over a goat or two.
I can send a cow.
We got cows here.
Thank you. That would be great. Would you like my address?
What?
Would you like my address?
Yes, please.
Yes. 1 Spooky Lane, Transylvania.
I'll send a cow right on the way.
Thank you. See you. Radio.
Okay, bye, brother.
We just love to get calls here. All right. Moving right along, nice we have something that ties in very well to what Brian was talking about, black cats, which is witches. Take it away, Natalia.
Okay, so a witch is not a Satanist, and their brooms were not for flying, but were used for cleansing rituals. And their hats at one point represented respect and authority from the local community. And you are unable to tell if a person is talking to a witch. Wait, yeah, because there's no preference for age nor clothing, and men could have been witches as well. And many witches didn't use cauldrons, candles, fires, or herbs, and none of them were ever supernatural.
I think we all know of a guy who's a witch.
We do.
Cough, cough.
Moving right along.
So, Natalia, how come there's a difference between witches and wizards if witches could be men? What's the difference? Do you know?
No.
If there is any? Like, did they do different things?
I think witches are more for evil rather than wizards. That's what
I
think.
I consider myself a wizard.
What?
Wait, what'd you say?
Continue.
Aren't guy witches called warlocks?
Warlocks? Yeah, I've heard that. I've heard that too. Term a lot. I never really knew what it...
It's a thing.
Thank you.
Yes, for clearing it up.
That's the perfect way to describe it. All right. Alyssa, why don't you tell us a little bit about Casper the Friendly Ghost now?
Okay, well, Casper was created in the late 1930s by Simeon Reed and Joe Oriolo. This creation was intended for a storybook that was supposed to come out in 1939. The rights to the storybook were then sold to Paramount Pictures' Famous Studios Animation Division. The Friendly Ghost, which was a novel tune, was released by Paramount in 1945. Casper did not like being friends with ghosts. He liked becoming friends with people. The only problem was he tried to become friends with human, but he initially scared almost everyone and only finds one cute little friend who becomes friends with him. Casper became one of the most famous properties of Famous Studios.
Has everyone seen that movie?
Yes, it's my favorite.
I love it.
I love Casper.
So good.
I've only seen it once, and it was like a long time ago, so I don't remember that well.
We should play it.
No, the movie is really good.
Yeah.
It is. Does anyone have anything else to say about monsters? I remember Nisarg, I think it was, or Muhammad mentioned something about talking about Frankenstein. And then there was a whole argument about whether he was a Halloween monster or not.
I think that was Muhammad.
I don't think we have anything to say about Frankenstein. He's falling apart.
Aaron. I love you.
That was a good joke.
Well, happy Halloween, everyone.
As you can see, this Halloween edition was very well planned. Very well.
Leo, maybe you should sign out.
Educated.
That hurt in my heart.
WHIT Radio.
All right. Well, this was a very fun Halloween edition to do. So this is Leah signing out with WHIT Radio and the Jeffersonian Show. Thank you, everyone, for watching.
Put my hat back on.
The mash.
They did the monster mash.
The monster mash.
It was a graveyard smash.
They did the mash.
It caught on in a flash.
They did the mash.
They did the monster mash. The zombies were having fun.